Now, I was able to see this problem from the CE Board Exam Study Group. And then, medyo interesting siya, so gagawa natin ng tutorial. A vertical force daw, P equals 10 kilonewtons, is applied at the ends of cord AB of length 2 meters and spring AC. And then, the spring has an unstretched length of 2 meters and a spring constant of K equals 15 kilonewton per meter. Ayan. Now, essentially, our spring and cord AB, by the way, ito pala yung labels natin, hindi ko nalagay. This is point A, point B, and then ito naman yung point C. So, yung AB daw is initially 2 meters. Now, given sa figure na this is 2 meters, so, bale, yung member AB pala, or cord AB, this is initially horizontal. And then, sinabi rin na the spring has an unstretched length of 2 meters. So, itong spring BC, this is initially, ano rin, horizontal. Kasi 2 meters yung length niya. Paganyan. Now, yung makikita nyo sa figure sa libro would be yung in-apply na yung force P. So, what would happen to this member? So, what would happen in this configuration? Now, let's apply the force P. Bale, ito yung mangyayari. Ayan. Diba? The force P would pull cord AB saka yung spring such that the spring would elongate, but AB is a rigid body so it will not deform. Meaning, yung spring lang yung magde-deform. So again, this is point A, this is point B, and then this is point C naman. So, itong member AB, this is still initially, yung length niya is still 2 meters pa rin. But yung BC, nag-elongate na siya. So, this is what we have. So, yung isosolve natin would be this angle from the horizontal. And then, we are also tasked to find the tension in member AB. Yan. So, lipat na lang tayo sa OneNote para mas ma-layout talaga natin yung solution. So, ito yung problem natin. Ayan. Now, ito yung theta na kailangan natin i-compute according to the figure. And then, this is our spring constant. And then, yung vertical force is 10 kilonewtons as labeled. Now, the shortest possible solution can be formed by using the method of sections. Now, let's pass a cutting section dito such that we can reveal the force in member AC. So, mayayari dyan, the force in member AC is tensile kasi diba, nag-elongate siya. So, label natin to as AC. Ayan. And then, we have theta dyan. Hindi yan magmamatter kasi yung AB, pag ito yung cut natin, hindi na siya masasali. And then, we can take moments about point B. Now, before doing that, let's try to label the, anong tawag dito? The distances. So, ito yung titingnan natin. Alam kasi natin na 2 meters yan, yung AB. Diba, hindi siya magde-deform kasi yung spring lang yung magde-deform. So, kapag 2 meters yan, and then this is angle theta, then we can actually draw a triangle dito. Diba, we can form a straight line here, and then we have this triangle. Right triangle yan. So, this value, the horizontal distance would be 2 cosine theta. Kasi diba, cosine theta equals adjacent divided by hypotenuse. Now, the adjacent side to this angle is this one. So, sabihin natin A. Then, divided by the hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is 2. Yan. Therefore, the adjacent side is 2 cosine theta. Ayan. And then, ano naman yung length na to? I hope you would agree na this would be 2 sine theta. Kasi using the sine function, yan, we have opposite over hypotenuse. So, opposite divided by hypotenuse, which is 2. The opposite side would be 2 sine theta. So, ito yung distances na kailangan natin. silang dalawa. And so using these distances, makukuha na natin yung moment equation. Magmo-moment tayo sa point B para makuha natin yung AC. Ano yung force niya? So summation of moments about point B equals 0. Now, we can transmit AC patungo dito para mas magiging madali yung solution natin. So, i-transmit ko na lang yung AC. Diba, by the principle of transmissibility, I can move this anywhere along its line of action. Yan, ililipat ko to sa point na to. So that the horizontal component of AC will not cause a moment about point B. Again, this is to simplify our solution. So, what we are interested in, instead of the horizontal and vertical forces, yung vertical force na lang yung kailangan natin. So, this would be ACY, and then this is ACX naman. So, notice, yung ACX, line of action niya, tatama na sa point B. So, wala na yung kwenta. Hindi na natin siya isasali. Now, how can we get ACY? Ito yung medyo challenging na part sa problem na to. Now, again, we can draw a line here. And then, this is 2 sine theta, 2 cos theta. Now, the whole distance is 4 meters. Diba? Yung buong horizontal distance. Therefore, this distance pala, measured from here up to C, this would actually be 4, the whole distance, then bawasan natin ng 2 cosine theta. So, 4 minus 2 cos theta. Ayan. I hope agree lang. And then, we can get the hypotenuse, AC, yung length ng member AC. Pwede natin kunin yan. Now, we can use 2 sine theta and 4 minus 2 cos theta, but medyo it's a bit difficult to simplify. So, what we can do is, we can just apply the cosine law para mas madali. So, saan triangle yung i-consider natin? This whole triangle. We can consider this one. Yan. So, let's say this is side A, side B, side C. Label natin na. Side A, side B, side C. Now, di ba, for cosine law, we need a side and then the angle opposite to it. So, if I will use C squared, this one, ipipare ko siya sa angle na to. Now, my remaining distances are known kasi di ba, this is 2 meters and this side is 4 meters in total. Yan, 2 plus 2. So, C squared equals A squared plus B squared. So, 2 squared plus 4 squared. Then, minus 2AB. So, 2 times 2 times 4. Then, cosine of theta. Diba? This distance. I mean, this angle pala. Therefore, I can define C. Or, instead of C, gagawin ko na lang AC nu. Bale, yung stretch length na. Stretch length ng AC. So, yan. AC nu. Stretch length. So, this would be equal to square root of this expression, yung nasulat natin. Now, para mas maganda yung solution natin mamaya, yung AC nu natin, gagawin natin, isimplify natin siya. So, 2 squared plus 4 squared, magiging 4 plus 16, diba, 20. Then, minus 2 times 2, 4 times 4, 16. Then, cosine theta. Now, you can further simplify this by factoring out 4. Diba, 4 times parang 5 minus 4 cos theta. But, mas ano kasi siya, mas marami kang itatype sa calculator. So, I will just leave the equation as is. So, ito yung AC nyo natin. Yung stretch length ng AC. Now, yung stretch length ng AC, Diba, makukuha din natin yan. We can form an equation for this one. So, how can we do that? Now, move ko lang to. Yung AC nyo natin. And then, diba, kung meron tayong spring, and then we are trying to elongate it, let's say we have a force P. Diba, the spring deformation is defined by, ano nga yun, diba? P divided by K. The force P divided by the spring constant. So, the deformation, bale, yung, ano na lang, yung total length na lang. Total length ng, ano na lang, yung total stretch length ng AC, diba, this would be AC nu equals the unstretched length of AC, which is known, 2 meters, yan, unstretched length of 2 meters, and then plus the deformation, this one. So, P divided by K yan, therefore, it would be the force in member AC, or FAC na lang, divided by K. Na ano yung K? K is 15 kilonewton per meter. So, divide natin to by 15. Ayan. Again, we are considering this formula. So, AC nu is equal to AC, the old AC, yung original niya, which is 2 meters plus FAC divided by 15. Now, since this corresponds to a force, then papalitan ko na lang yung label natin dito. I will just label this as FAC na lang. So, this would be FACY, FACX. Ayan. Now, alam ko na yung value ng hypotenuse. So, diba, yung FACY, I can reduce this one into a component of FAC. So, this would be FAC times the vertical distance, considering this triangle, we have 2 sine theta. So, wait lang. 2 sine theta. Move ko lang to. Medyo sagabal siya. And then, we can divide this by the length of AC. Diba, vertical distance divided by hypotenuse para makuha natin yung component ng force. So, this length is equal to this one, AC nu. Diba, yan yung hypotenuse natin using the cosine law. So, we have square root of 20 minus 16 cosine theta. Ayan. So, ito yung FAC natin. Now, again, we have to take moments at point B for our solution to be efficient. So, move ko lang to, ah. And then, again, moment about B, we have 10 kilonewtons multiplied by a distance of 2 cosine theta. Force times perpendicular distance. Now, it will cause a clockwise rotation. So, 10 times 2 cos theta. Now, notice that FACY, or the Y component of AC, it causes a counterclockwise rotation about B. So, what if equate ko na lang yung clockwise moment saka counterclockwise moment? So, equating both, we have FACY, which is equivalent to FAC times 2 sine theta. Then, divide ko yan by square root of 20 minus 16 cosine theta. Ayan. Then, I have to multiply this by its moment arm. Now, if I will transmit, diba, dito galing yung FAC natin. Tapos, tinransmit natin siya dito. So, the moment arm of FACY will also change. This force, the perpendicular distance going to point B, is already 2 plus 2. So, 4 meters yung buong moment arm niya. So, times 4 pala to. Ayan. So, ito na yung equation natin. So, we can define FAC as 10 2 cos theta this expression, then divide mo na lang yung expression na to by the coefficient of FAC. So this is to be divided by 2 sine theta over square root of 20 minus 16 cosine theta multiplied by 4. Yan. This expression divided by this coefficient. Now, meron na tayong FAC in terms of theta. Notice na theta na lahat ng variables. And then in our equation here, this one, we can also define this in terms of theta lahat. Now, what is AC nu? AC nu is the hypotenuse of this triangle, which was square root of 20 minus 16 cos theta, yung nakuha natin earlier. So, this is AC nu. Yan. And then, equal yan to 2, the initial length, plus FAC, which is this value. Yan, itong buong expression, this is FAC. Color na lang natin ah. FAC yan. This one. And then divided by 15. Now, solve daw natin yung theta. Since yan na lang yung unknown sa nabuong equation natin. So we have square root of 20 minus 16 cosine theta. And then equals 2 plus we have 10. Then 2 cos theta divided by 2 sine theta over square root of 20 minus 16 cosine theta tapos multiplied by 4. Then divide natin yung buong expression by 15. Then solving theta, syntax error. Nakulangan pala ng parenthesis. So solving theta, we have, let's say 45 yung assumed angle ko. We have 34.99. So theta equals this value. Ayan. Now since gagamitin pa natin to, let me just store this one sa, let's say, variable A para sa angle natin. So our answer for number 1 is letter C. Compute the angle theta for equilibrium. And then, for number 2, what is the tension in chord AB daw? Now, itong question na to, since meron na tayong theta, medyo madali na lang siya. So gagawin natin, depende yan sa diskarte mo, you can make two equilibrium equations, summation of forces along x and y, or you can still apply the method of sections. However, yung method of sections mo para sa number 2 would already entail this one. Instead na ito yung cut mo, since you're already interested in AB, then your cut must reveal the internal force sa member AB. So, ito yung magiging cut natin. Now, this cut will reveal the force in member AB. So, ito yan. This is FAB. But then, alam na natin yung theta. So, medyo madali na lang. So, gagawin ko, I will just transmit this one, just like what we did earlier. Transmit ko to sa point na to. Hindi na-copy. Wait lang. Ayan. So, andito na yung FAB. This is to reduce our equation since we are still essentially considering the section to the right so that we can include 10 kilonewtons sa equation natin. Ayan. So, gagawin ko, I will sum up moments about sa C naman ako magmo-moment. Equal to 0. Now, sir, bakit kanina hindi mo siya pwedeng i-consider to the left? if to the left kasi ako, then I will be essentially considering joint B. Hindi yan pwede. Hindi ka pwede mag-section sa joint kasi yung matitira na lang is only this force, so magiging zero siya. Wala kang masasolve dyan. So ito na lang. Essentially ha, we are considering the section to the right, but we just transmitted the force in AB. Tinransmit natin siya dito para mas maging efficient yung solution natin. But essentially, to the right talaga yung section natin na kinonsider. So, i-clarify ko lang yan kasi dyan usually nagkakamali yung mga students. So, we have FAB. What we are interested in is only the vertical component. Kasi yung horizontal component ng FAB, tatama siya. Yung line of action niya tatama sa point C. So, hindi na siya kasali. So, this is essentially FABX. This is FABY. Now, FABY is FAB. Then, alam na natin yung theta. Yan. But, in terms of, ano na lang, in terms of the distances, ano na lang, gawin na lang natin FB sine theta. Yan, mas madali pala. Kasi kapag in terms of the distances, mas magiging mahaba siya. So, we have FAB sine theta. Ayan. So, moment about C, we have FAB sine theta, it will cause a clockwise rotation about C. So, FAB then sine theta, yung theta natin, naka-store sa letter A. So, type ko na lang siya as letter A. And then, my moment arm is 2 plus 2, which is 4. And then, we have 10 kilonewtons, which will cause a counterclockwise rotation about point C. So, minus 10 ako. And then, multiply ko to by 4 minus 2 cosine theta. Move lang natin to. Again, 10 times 4 minus 2 cosine theta, which is nakastore sa letter A. Then, equate to 0. So, we have x sine theta times 4 minus 10 times 4 minus 2 cosine theta, equate to 0. We have 10.295 or approximately 10.3. And then this is kilonewtons. Yan. By the way, KN pala to. Ginawa ko kasi yung SI yung units. Naka-pounds kasi siya sa initial given natin. KN yan lahat. So, we have 10.3. Ayan. Now, yung FAC naman, if you want to compute it, then you can use this one. Yung summation of moments about B natin kanina. So, try down natin. We have 10 times 2 cos theta, then divided by 2 sine theta over square root of 20 minus 16 then cosine theta. Yeah. Double check ko lang ah. 2 sine theta tama lang. Then times 4. So 9.38. This is kilonewtons. Ayan. So, ito na yung mga unknowns natin. Ito, additional lang. If ever, ito yung hinahanap. Sige, salamat sa pagkikinig.